Hi everyone, in this video, you'll learn what the accessibility tree is, how to access it in Chrome, and about the different information exposed in the accessibility tree. We'll end with examples of using the accessibility tree to debug and a way to use it to check custom widgets for accessibility. Quick tip, if the accessibility tree is intimidating, you can also try using the WAVE extension. WAVE exposes all the ARIA on the page in the Details tab, and the accessibility names of interactive elements in the Order tab. I'm using Chrome version 119.0.6045.123. Let's get started. First, the accessibility tree is objects that make up the page's content. It is based on the web page's DOM. While the DOM shows all the website data, the accessibility tree only shows accessibility data. It filters out any information from the DOM that doesn't have to do with accessibility. Here's an example comparing the DOM with the accessibility tree. The code is for a banner with a link. In the DOM, the banner starts with a section, which translates to a section in the accessibility tree. Back to the DOM, there are two divs with classes. The accessibility tree classifies these as ignored and generic, which means they don't have any accessibility information. Lastly, in the DOM, we have an H1, span with text, and link. In the accessibility tree, the H1 is a heading, the span is static text, and the link is a link. Assistive technology uses the accessibility tree to interpret the content on the page. So how the element is displayed in the accessibility tree affects how assistive technology reads it. Now, let's open the accessibility tree in Chrome. Right-click anywhere on the page. At the bottom of the menu, select Inspect. In the Elements pane, select the Switch to Accessibility Tree View icon to switch back and forth between the DOM and accessibility tree. If you don't see that icon, then in the Styles pane, select the More Tabs arrow icon. Then select Accessibility. Under the Accessibility Tree dropdown, select Enable Full Page Accessibility Tree. Then select Reload DevTools in the pop-up. In that same accessibility pane is detailed accessibility information for selected elements. When you access the full accessibility tree in the Elements pane, you get all the parent and child relationship information. As you switch between the DOM and the accessibility tree, the same element stays selected. This helps you understand how the accessibility tree interprets the DOM. The Accessibility pane has an ARIA Attributes and Computed Properties dropdown. ARIA Attributes lists all the ARIA attributes attached to that HTML element. Here's an example. In the DOM, this input has the attributes ARIA Autocomplete, Active Descendant, and Controls. In the Accessibility pane, there are the same ARIA attributes listed with their values. Computed properties tell you how assistive technology will interpret the DOM. Most elements will have a name, role, and additional properties depending on the element. The name is the accessible name. For this input, the name is website. This is the name assistive technologies use for the element. Under name are all the attributes that could affect the accessible name. Going through the list, I get that the name comes from the label. If I added an ARIA label that equals groups, the accessible name changes to groups because ARIA label trumps the HTML label. The role is the type of object that element is. For example, this H1's role is heading, this button's role is button, and the combo box's role is combo box. Other properties like description, state, or how to interact with it can be listed depending on the element. One way to use the accessibility tree is for debugging. For example, this image has alternative text in the alt attribute. That alt text should be announced by a screen reader, but it isn't. So I'll right-click, select Inspect, and then use the Element Selector to select the image and find its code in the DOM. Now I'll switch to the accessibility tree, and the accessibility tree has the image as ignored. The accessibility pane has ARIA hidden as an ARIA attribute, and under computed properties, it says accessibility node not exposed. So ARIA hidden is removing the image from the accessibility tree. I'll remove ARIA hidden, and now the name is the alt text. It is also helpful for debugging accessibility name issues because it tells you the accessible name and lists all the attributes that could affect it and which one is actually used. Another way to use the accessibility tree is to check custom widgets. W3C has patterns for building accessible widgets like accordions, combo boxes, and feeds, to name a few. Most of these patterns include using ARIA to make the interaction accessible. The accessibility tree exposes the parent and children relationships and all the ARIA used, making it easier to check the widget. For example, some of the combo box pattern suggestions are setting the combo box element role to combo box, and ARIA expanded set to false when the pop-up is not visible, and true when it is. Each of these can be quickly checked in the accessibility tree. I just go to the combo box element and review the ARIA attributes and computed properties to make sure I'm following the pattern correctly. You're ready to use the accessibility tree to debug issues and check interactive widgets for accessibility.